Hi, math class. Over the next couple of classes, we're going to be looking at some things that I think will probably look suspiciously like algebra to some of you. And that's because it kind of is. We're kind of touching on some algebra topics. And the reason that we're doing that, though, is because it's all math that you know how to do. And I think they disguise it as and call it a big scary name of algebra. And then people think that they can't do it. But you can do it. And just to sort of ease into this, we're going to define some things. So the first thing we're going to define, what are equations? Because that sounds like a scary algebra word, right? Equation. What does that mean? It simply means a statement that says two amounts are equal. So you have an equal sign, and whatever you're doing on one side of the equal sign has to be equal to the other side of the equal sign. That's all it means. You're finding a balance between these two sides. But sometimes in algebra, an equation will often have a variable. So you might be thinking, ack, well, what's a variable then? And I say, don't worry. The variable is that letter that's used to represent an unknown amount. So people, you know, let's be honest, this is the part that sometimes makes algebra seem very scary and indecipherable, right? Like, oh my gosh, there's a letter in my equation. What do I do with it? I often joke that I need a t-shirt that says, and then Satan put the alphabet in math. And what do you know? People have made that t-shirt. But what I want you to do is change the way that you think, okay? So don't think that it's a bad thing. Think of it more as math with letters, challenge accepted, because this is all math that you can do, I promise. All it means is we're figuring out how to make one side of the equal sign, again, balanced with the other side of the equal sign. What do I mean by that? Let's look at an example. 8 plus m equals 15. Ack, there's this scary variable right there, right? No, you can totally do this because you know what number you need to add to 8 to make 8 equal 15. You know this. Hopefully you're thinking, oh, it's 7, which is correct. If we say 7 right here, 8 plus 7 is going to make this side equal 15 and this side equal 15. And if you want to write it all fancy and make yourself feel like a real mathematician, you'll say m equals 7. Okay, so some of you might be feeling like it should be harder than this. So for all you doubters, let's look at another example. 3a equals 24. So anytime that a number is right up next to a letter or a variable, so see right here in 3a, it means multiply. So hopefully you're thinking to yourself, okay, 3 times something has to equal 24. And I know my multiplication facts, so I know that this is going to be 8, because 3 times 8 is the only thing that will balance it out and equal 24. And again, if you want to make it look all mathematician-like, then it'll be A equals 8, just like that. Okay, so you might be asking, all right, Heidi, but what about if there's two letters in equation? What do we do then? Because that really does look scary. So this is called a formula. And again, so it's something that you can solve. It's simply a tool that's going to help you to solve a problem. It's going to help you. It's not a scary thing. To use a formula, you're going to substitute into the equation all of the information that you know, and then solve for the information that you don't know. Because even though they're putting a letter in there, they're going to be giving you that information anyway. Let's look at an example for this. So one of the most used equations is the area equation, which states that area equals L times W. Or you might see it without the multiplication mark. You might just see that L and that W right up next to each other. So when we're looking at a rectangle, the L means the length and W means the width. So this is often information that they're going to give us. So we can plug in the information that they tell us into these L and W variables. Okay, so let's look at a rectangle. Here it is. And we've got our equation here, A equals L times W. And it tells us that one side of this rectangle is 8 and the other side is 12. Okay, so we're going to plug into our formula all of the information that we know. And because they've told us information and we're keeping our positive mindset and thinking to ourselves that math with letters, no problem, challenge accepted, right? They've told us that the length is 12 and the width is 8. So I know that L is going to be 12. I'm simply going to put that into my equation. And that W, the width, is 8. I'm just going to write that into my equation. And then I know that 12 times 8 is 96, right? Oh, I went too fast. 12 times 8 is 96. So that's going to be the answer to my area formula. So we'll be talking more about this area thing and what it means. But let's review some things, to sort of summarize this particular video. The first thing that I really want you to remember is that letters in an equation or a formula, they're not scary. This is all math, again, that you can totally do. And often students, will get to a place where they are so freaked out by it that, they're unable to do the math because they're derailed by the letters. So my recommendation, don't stop breathing. And if you get freaked out, please tell me, because we can walk through it and hopefully start to kind of see that again, like number one, that these things are not scary. An equation, it's simply a statement that needs to be balanced. It's a way of showing that two amounts, one on either side of an equal sign, truly are equal. A variable, it's a non-scary letter that represents something that we don't know yet, but we can easily figure out. And a formula is an equation with more than one of these non-scary variables. And above all, what I want you to remember is that you can do this. This is all math that we've talked about before. We were just writing it a little bit different way and giving it a scary name of algebra. Please don't get derailed. Okay? Does that sound good? Hopefully this is something you're willing to try, and we'll try it when you get to class.